Namaskaram, Bhagavad Gita, 2nd chapter, sloka 70. In this sloka, Bhagavan compares Chittapragyan with ocean. In earlier sloka, he compared him with tortoise, which withdraws its limbs and head whenever there is a disturbance outside. And he compared with the bee, the one who has desires, and one who is towards material pleasures. He is like a bee which caught in the flower. Because it went on sucking the honey, so the flower closed the petals and the bee could not come out of the flowers. And it got killed by elephant. And here he is explaining how desire affects the people and how Jnani is away from all the desires and how Jnani is not tempted by any object. So here, there how that like tortoise, Jnani withdraws his sensual organs away from objects. So here he is saying he is like ocean. The rivers carry water towards the ocean and finally in their final portion of the journey they flow into the ocean and bring all the water to the ocean. But ocean does not change its quality. So ocean remains the same. And ocean is not overflowing because of water from the rivers. And it keeps calm. We don't find any change because the rivers flowing into the ocean. So Chittapragyan is like this. He has got so many objects around him, despite that he remains undisturbed. So he remains calm. So that is what explained here by Bhagavan. So like how the ocean which has got water on all sides but remain calm, though the rivers bring water, here he has got all objects surrounding but he is not affected by that because his mind is only towards God. Though you use objects, even while using objects, he is not getting attracted towards the objects. And he uses objects for bodily necessities, for example, food, water. But he is not getting attached to food and water. Whereas we get attached to the particular brand, particular quality, and we want only this kind of food and only from this place we need food. So we have got all these desires. Whereas Jnani can live with the object but without attachment. So those objects are also for the bodily necessities. And even if he doesn't get it, he lives without them. So, or being bereft of them. So, he can live, he lives without them. If he doesn't get a particular food, because he is not choosy about food. So, whatever he gets, he eats. So, that is the nature of Chittapragyan or steady-minded person, Jnani. Such a person attains peace. The person who has got more desires does not attain peace because he is not concentrating towards God and he is very particular about getting more this particular product or particular brand and is adding on his desires. So naturally he will not have any peace of mind. So this is what beautifully explained in this sloka. In 71st sloka, Lord Krishna advises Arjuna to be away from material desires, greediness, ego and proprietorship. So in this sloka he says Jnani or Chittapragyan does not have any likes. He is away from I-ness and minus. He never has a feeling of I or he never has a feeling of this is mine. So that Inus and Minus are missing in Jnani. So that should not be there. So he is advising Arjuna not to have all these qualities. So give up this material desires, because material desires only make us greedy about things, because we like to have more and more and we get trapped in material world. So that is a problem. So naturally our mind gets attracted or attached towards that object. So we are not able to eliminate the desire from our mind. So that's a problem he is facing. Then next, greed. Greed, when you have more material, what happens? Material, that is objects, there is a greed for material advancement. So you like to have more and more, and there is no end for our chasing the products, because we literally run after the products to get it. So this is what happens to us. So number one, we spend our money there, and we spend our energy there, we spend our time in getting more and more objects. So we are into the material world and we are missing the permanent happiness, and we are missing what is to be attained in this birth. So that is what told by Lord Krishna here. So those who possess the wealth of contentment possess one of the biggest treasures of life. So when you are contented with what you have, then there will not be search for things. So you will not become greedy. The next one, ego. So ego, it stops us to coexist with others. So you find, whether it is in workplace or at home, we find there are interpersonal issues. They arise only because of ego. So the problem is, we people have that egoistic mind that has to be removed. So Lord Krishna tells Arjuna not to have that egoistic mind. So this is very, very important for us, because we all live with the egoistic mind. That is why we find difficult to get adjusted with people around us, whether it's a family or outside in a workplace. So you find, no, some people, they keep on quitting their jobs. They are always in search of another job. That is because they are not able to get along with that situation, with the people there. That is because of egoism. And this we can experience even in our house, in our family, because we are not able to accept others' view, because we feel we are only right. So that never gives us peace of mind. The next one, proprietorship, that is ownership. Nothing is ours. Everything belongs to God. So we have it only for time being. And we come to the earth with empty handed and leave the earth empty handed. So how can we claim everything is ours? So we are not the owners. So there should not be proprietorship. So if there is no proprietorship, naturally we will not have attachment towards the property, because finally we are leaving everything here. We are leaving even this body on the earth and go. The soul goes to another body. So nothing is ours. So how can we think of worldly things as ours? So this sloka gives us guidance to view our life and handle it beautifully. 72nd sloka, which is the last sloka of 2nd chapter, Sankhya Yogam. In this sloka, Bhagavan talks about Brahmasthiti, the final stage of life of Siddha Prajnan. He attains Brahmam. He is in the state of God realization. He is away from delusion. He doesn't have any Maya. He is not covered by the, completely away from Maya. And he is at the Brahmam stage. So you will be attaining the Brahman for sure. And since he is in the state of God realization, God bestows him divine knowledge, divine bliss, divine love. So sanchit karmas are destroyed for him, and avidya is dispelled, and the three doshas, that is the effects of materially conditioned state, are removed, and panch koshas, that is five sheets of material energy, are burnt, and soul becomes free from bondage. So this is the state of Sthita Prajnan. So he is liberated soul now, and even while living, he is not attracted towards the object. So he is referred to be as Jivan Mukta. Even while living, he is away from, his mind is away from those objects, sense objects. So he is Jivan Mukta. So his liberation is a natural consequence of God realization. So this is how the life of Sthita Prajnan, or the person with steady mind and who has got complete focus on God, who has got the thoughts of God in his mind always. So here in this chapter, Bhagavan explained under four topics. First one, Arjuna was wrong in his logic and reasoning. Then second, Bhagavan says, correcting his logical thinking. Number three, Bhagavan gives practical guidance to him. Fourth one, Bhagavan explains the attributes of people who follow his teachings. So we learnt about Sthita Prajnan in the last few slokas. He explained about the Sthita Prajnan. So now we have the complete picture of a person when he follows the teaching of what Lord Bhagavan has given to us. We will be attaining this state of God realization. One of the Pavasarams of Buddha Thalvar explains this. உளதென்று இருமாவார் உண்டில்லை என்று தளர்தல் அதன் அருகுஞ்சாரார் அளவறிய வேதத்தான் வேங்கடத்தான் விண்ணோர் முடிதோயும் பாதத்தான் பாதம் பயின்று. So in this sloka, in this pasuram, he says, the Lord of Thiruvenkatam, worshipped by the gods in the sky, is himself the Vedas, whose meanings are endless. If devotees worship his feet, they will have no pride, whether they are rich or poor. So this is the truth we should understand to lead our life without getting attached to material.